many of you guys have summer jobs? Yeah. All right.
Then you go to college. So I got a couple notes here. How many people here are familiar? How many people here are familiar with the Cardinal Cowboy? All right. How many people here are Cardinal fans? I need you to put it in this concert. Well, I'll tell you the short version of what happened with me.
I'm going to ask you some questions after we're done.
There was a truck speeding out of control. Ran into us head on. The driver of that truck later blew a .21. That was his blood alcohol content. A .21 nowadays is almost three times the legal limit. Needless to say, he was not capable of driving, even though he was. We were in hell out of that truck. I was on the side of the highway at that point talking to the paramedics. And the paramedics said, you know what? Carter's okay. Go ahead without him. I started to have seizures. They stopped the ambulance. They took the truck driver out to hit us. They put me in the ambulance. They said, had I not made that first trip to St. John's Mercy, not on his mercy, I would not have survived. But how many of you would agree that my career path at that point had changed? An aspiring baseball player, one of the single words is Andy Freeze, about an hour, things were looking good. Next thing, I'm in a coma. The doctors gave me less than 50-50 odds to live or die. I think I proved it wrong. Do you guys agree? Yeah. for the rest of his life. Needless to say, we proved him wrong again. I ended up going to same school, same college, went to grad school, got a master's in media communications, and went to work for the largest brewery in the world. How many people are familiar with Anheuser-Busch? Great company. Did not drink until 21 years of age. Drink responsibly. Nobody here's been a drinker. But I was truly put to the test to where I have a huge advantage. I have a huge advantage because I know what it's like to be pushed near death, to be pushed to the edge where the doctors say he's not going to survive.
I was put to the test.
before somebody else has even gotten up to try once. They might be smarter, they might be faster, they might be stronger, they might be more talented, they may have more skills, but I got out there and I tried 10 times, failing 9 times, potentially, before they even tried once. Do you see what kind of an advantage that gives you? Do you see how you can beat the guy who's smarter, who's faster? Hard work, dedication, singing through. How many of you guys plan on graduating? Great. Let's see it. How many plan on getting a great job? How many plan on going to college? How many plan to run your own company? All right, now we're talking. You see, that there are going to be hurdles. There are going to be things you think you can't overcome. But the truth is, it's just a test. The test is, are you going to quit? Because as soon as you quit, you start over. But if you bounce back, you continue on, and now you've learned from what other people failed at, even what you might have failed at, but you continue, and you never quit. The key to making it, guys, is you never stop. Now, there's a couple big things in life that make things difficult. But I can tell you, if you want to give yourself the biggest challenges, if you want to make life as difficult as possible, then doing drugs is one of the best ways to make life as difficult as possible. I can tell you from watching friends who got involved with drugs, they were talented, they were ambitious, they had so much to offer, but they got involved with drugs and literally destroyed their lives. They had everything going for them. They were smarter, faster, bigger, stronger, but got involved with drugs and destroyed their lives. Alcohol is the same way, kids. Alcohol is just as bad. I know people who let alcohol, even after they were 21 or 8 years of age, obviously, destroy their lives. Stay away from these. Don't abuse these things. Wait. Certainly wait until you're of age. But if you want to assure your success, stay away from drugs. Stay away from alcohol. And the last thing I can tell you that really made me a huge advantage that I didn't even realize was so instrumental. How many people here have ever volunteered for an organization, for a charity, for an event, for a group? I can tell you guys the most rewarding thing, the connections I've made with pro athletes, with owners of some of the most prolific companies in the world, and some of the Cardinal organizations here in St. Louis, I wouldn't have met had I decided, you know what, I wanted to give back. And where I thought I was really going to help them, I thought I was really giving something to them, I later realized I gained so much in return. And in return, I grew more than I ever could have otherwise. So I would strongly advocate you find something that you love. Find your passion. What is your passion? Is it to be a teacher? Is it to be a pilot? Is it to be a doctor? Is it to be a business owner? Find your passion and never, ever stop until you get there. How many of you guys are with me? Everybody smile. good one.